Tampons and pads are necessities for women around the world, but for many, it's a struggle to pay for them. That's where Tampon Tuesday comes in. It's an initiative that was started here in London 9 years ago and aims to provide feminine hygiene products to women in our community who can't afford them. And it's since gone national. Kelda Yuen has the story.
Here at the London Food Bank, the shelves are stocked with tampons and pads, but that wasn't always the case.
Before Tampon Tuesday, we were only giving a few per woman, and now we're able to give multiple amounts of that. So we're giving at least 10 pads and 10 tampons to every woman that comes in that needs them.
And many women who come in do need them. Years ago, one of them was Mandy Fields. She was in the non-food section and noticed something missing.
And I saw that there was shampoo and diapers, and there wasn't any feminine hygiene products.
And Mandy knows firsthand how it feels to struggle with the stigma of poverty. According to the Canadian Women's Foundation, 1.5 million women in the country live in poverty.
I used to be so ashamed of the poverty and having to ask my friends for the product, and there is no shame in poverty.
It was with this in mind that she began Tampon Tuesday back in 2009.
Our first event, we had 6 people show up.
That number, though, only kept growing. With each second Tuesday of every month, more people joined the networking event, bringing with them a box of feminine hygiene product to be donated to the food bank.
Knowing that now people can get tampons and pads here means that they don't, that's one less stress they have to deal with because they're very costly.
Women shouldn't have to choose between buying milk and bread for their children and buying basic need products. This is about dignity. It's about respect. This is a bodily function for half of the population, women, for half of their lives.
And the initiative grew not only in London, but across the country. This year, 29 cities are taking part.
From the Yukon, Chatham, Sudbury, Halifax, everywhere in between, Vancouver Island.
In BC, local transit is helping to transport donated boxes from all of the events to food banks, shelters, and crisis centers. Shoppers Drug Mart has also become a sponsor, contributing funds to promote the cause and more.
We had donated $30,000 worth of product that's being distributed to food banks across the country.
Besides providing women in poverty with a necessity they often can't afford, Tampon Tuesday also hopes to remove the stigma associated with a natural bodily function, menstruation.
I think that, you know, these terms are, they bring on shame for some people. They bring on curiosity for others. Mostly they're just things that we don't talk about.
And what a time for us to be talking about it in terms of the Me Too movement. Time's up, and it really is time's up for us to be ashamed of having our period.
Kelda Yuen, CTV News.